I'm Rusty Lowe, and I'm part of the Globe Observer Mosquito Habitat Mapper Science Team. So if you're not familiar, here is the Globe Observer app. And on this app, you can find the Mosquito Habitat Mapper. All you need to do is download this free app to your mobile device. And the Globe Observer app connects you with more than 60,000 citizen scientists around the world who are collecting observations that support NASA science. What I thought I'd do today is talk just a little bit about how we came up with this idea. I haven't always been studying mosquitoes, but before I started working with Globe Observer, I was a college professor in Nebraska. I worked in the School of Natural Resources, and I taught in the Environmental Science Department, and I taught climate change. My field of research specialization is the study of climate change taking place on 1,000 to 10,000 year timescales. And this is something that we do by looking at the fossils and the chemicals that are preserved in lake sediments. And these proxies preserve the record of changing temperature and moisture. And while this data is really exciting for me and speaks to me, it wasn't compelling to everyone I know, including people that are really important to me, like my dad and some of my friends and family and a few of my students. So as a result, I was always trying to think of different ways to communicate how present-day climate change is real, it's happening right now, and it's already impacting our lives in a really concrete way. And I also recognize that there's so much variability in day-to-day temperature and precipitation. It's no wonder a lot of people can't track the current warming by just validating with their own experience. So we have to look elsewhere for that validation. And I was thinking, what can we point to that shows how climate change is already impacting our lives day to day? Well, if you're reading the news right now, you've probably heard about murder hornets. This is an invasive species that they are expecting to come into the US. And like many invasive species, they are expanding their ranges around the world. And this is because of changes in climate that make places that were previously unsuitable now able to support these organisms. So, you know, our biomes are shifting, plants and animals are moving to higher latitudes, and they're also climbing up to higher elevations that they couldn't occupy before, and they're taking advantage of these new niches. So environmental conditions are changing, and these new areas are meeting their needs. So some of these shifts are putting organisms in contact with people where they have, in ways that they haven't had and they haven't been interacting with before. So back to my dilemma about how this relates to climate change in everyday lives. Well, I was just thinking, you know, what could be more concrete and more personal and connected to our personal mosquito, to our personal experience than something that bites you, you know, like a mosquito, right? So those of us who've been spending time outside have been informally and probably also unconsciously tracking our personal experience with mosquitoes. In some parts of the world, people are noticing that the mosquito season is coming earlier and it's staying longer than in recent memory. In other parts of the world and in parts of the U.S., especially right now in the South and on the East Coast, people are complaining that the mosquitoes seem to be a lot more aggressive than they remember, and the bites are a lot more painful. Well, in fact, this is exactly what is happening. The science is validating these personal experiences that people have, and they've been noticing with respect to mosquitoes. So in sum, I would say, okay, in about 94% of major US cities, to take an example, the number of days where residents have risk of a mosquito-borne disease and having it transmitted by mosquitoes has increased. Some places like Reno, Nevada, the mosquito season now is a full month and a half longer than when I was a kid in the 1970s. Where I live here in Colorado, you know, it's about 2 weeks longer. And about those bites, we're seeing the northward migration of two invasive mosquito species, Aedes albopictus and Aedes aegypti. Both of these mosquitoes are very aggressive daytime biters, which means people are going to encounter them more frequently. They are also vectors of several viruses that cause disease and diseases that were formerly only found in the subtropics and tropics. These include Zika, dengue, chikungunya, and yellow fever. And these two species now are also implicated in the transmission of West Nile virus, which has been a problem in the States for some 30 years. So what I want to do now is show you a map where you can see the projected range expansion of Aedes aegypti. In blue, you'll see where we find the species today. This range began to establish itself in the 1970s after we stopped using DDT. So the blue shows expansion until the 1970s. Now the red is where we expect to see these species expanding in 50 years. And the yellow is where we will project this mosquito's range will be in 2080. So as you can see, mosquitoes are already posing a big global health problem, and that problem is projected to become more serious, more expanded in range, and more serious in a warming climate. So here's your chance to make a difference. Record your observations about mosquitoes using the app, the Mosquito Habitat Mapper tool on the Globe Observer app. What you will do is you will report where you find mosquito larvae and breeding sites where you dump out containers and basically mitigate that site so those juveniles can't grow up to budding adults. And if you want, you can also use the Mosquito Habitat Mapper key to describe the kind of mosquito that you've encountered. As a postscript, if you're staying inside right now, you can look back around at standing water, even in your house. Last summer, a friend of mine found a very productive breeding site in a bucket in her basement that she'd forgotten when she was painting. And last spring, my daughter gave me Mother's Day flowers. And about a week and a half later, that water where the flowers were was teeming with mosquito larvae. They were all swimming around in that vase. So you never know where you can find them. And by dumping those out, we got rid of the potential of a lot of adults flying around my house and biting me. So that's important work. So there are all kinds of places where you can look for mosquito larvae in and around your home. Some favorite habitats that I know about are wet areas under sinks. If you have a little bit of a leak down there and it puddles sometimes, that's a favorite place. Sinks. So besides sinks, there's under flower pots, people sometimes have dishes. That's also a really preferred habitat. Trash piles is one place where I've found mosquitoes over the course of the last couple summers. And of course, used tires that are laying around, you know, old used tires are laying around both in urban and in rural settings. And that is a preferred habitat for a lot of mosquitoes for breeding sites for their babies, nurseries, I guess, for their babies. So anyway, I hope you'll join the more than 60,000 citizens using the Globe Observer app. I hope you'll be able to report mosquito at your mosquito observations. And in doing so, you'll make the world a better place. So stay healthy and stay safe.